I'm Matt Towery for Insider Advantage, the Internet News Agency, and the Southern Political Report. Of course, breaking news all over the place today. First, Fred Thompson out of the race. We'll address that in a moment. But for the moment, let's talk about something that isn't getting a lot of attention, and that is the Democratic race for the presidential primary in Florida. Of course, the candidate's not allowed to campaign down there, but in the end, it could become a very important sort of launching pad going into California, which is viewed to be very similar to Florida. With me is Tricia Ruggiero, who's been with our company for many years. Tricia, how about telling the folks the results of the poll, which we took just last night, which has a margin of error of 4%?
Sure. In a survey of 547 likely Democratic voters in Florida, the results were Clinton at 46%, Obama at 30%, Edwards at 13%, undecided came in at 6%, and other at 5%.
And what is this that we have right
now? Well, this is our latest Florida Insider magazine hitting the streets today.
And that will be out in Florida in the next few days. So if you're part of the media, you'll also be getting it. It has included a presidential primer that tells you everything from the geography and how people vote in Florida, goes into past stories of presidential races, and also some pretty important facts that you wouldn't know unless you're in the Sunshine State all the time, as our Gary Reese, head of our Florida Insider Bureau down in Tallahassee, is. Of course, we're pleased to provide polling services for numerous groups in Florida, including the Florida Chamber of Commerce. We feel like we know Florida better than most folks. And of course, my column, national column, which is syndicated around the country, emanates out of the Florida Times Union, Jacksonville's newspaper. Thanks for joining me on set today, Tricia.
Thank you.
Thanks, Tricia, for joining me. My colleague, Aileen Page, has been on vacation. She'll be returning shortly. In the meantime, a lot of breaking news to cover. On Tuesday, Fred Thompson gets out of the race. What effect will that have in Florida? Well, our tracking polling that we've been doing in Florida showed that Thompson only had about 4 to 5% of the vote. That's not a lot, but it could potentially have some impact. We'll have to keep watching that. Also of importance in Florida, and something which no one had really noted, and that is a massive number of people have already voted in Florida. So the polling that has been done, we've not released. Now, I will tell you, our internal polling has shown John McCain with a lead, but everyone bunched up fairly closely together. But just like every other pollster, we've been asking the question up until now, how will you vote on Tuesday? In other words, if the election were held today, who would you vote for? We haven't asked the critical question, who did you vote for? Hundreds of thousands of voters in Florida have already cast their vote over the last few weeks, and those polls do not reflect those votes. So consequently, on Wednesday, there will be an Insider Advantage majority opinion poll that will come out, which will include those who have already voted. That will be critical to get some handle on where this race really is. We don't know if Rudy Giuliani, being camped out in Florida for weeks, got him a lot of votes early on, whether John McCain got a huge boost coming out of New Hampshire, and that got him some votes. So we really don't know where the race is. None of the polls that are coming out right now are taking into account that early voting. That's something you have to do. So look for the gold standard in Florida to be the Insider Advantage majority opinion poll, which will come out on Wednesday, showing how people not only are likely to vote, but also how they have voted. Now, of course, other news today, big news. We talked about it actually on our Monday evening bulletin. Then all day Tuesday, we talked about it. Going into Wednesday, the big discussion around the country, the economy. 2 years ago, we wrote about it. I wrote about it in my Florida Times Union column, which was syndicated nationally. I said the housing market, which seemed to be going gangbusters, was going to be the beginning of the end for the economy for the United States. We were going to have some real tough times going down the road. Perhaps that's a little bit of hyperbole. It wasn't the beginning of the end, but certainly it was the beginning of the recession that we're now likely in. Written about it over and over again. I hope you look at the review of the columns that were written, and I have to give the credit where the credit is due. It goes to Insider Advantage polling. Our polling, which we poll every night, told us how consumers were feeling, how homeowners were feeling, how much they were saving, how much they were using, how much they were borrowing on their houses. And we came to the conclusion 2 years ago, when no one else was talking about housing, that there was going to be a huge burst in the housing bubble. It was going to take place first in Florida, California, the growth states, and then spread around the country, and now perhaps around the world. This is a very serious situation. The Fed comes in, gives a rate cut early in the morning on Tuesday that scared markets overseas and didn't necessarily solve the problem, and it's going to be probably on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, what have you done for me lately? The politicians are going to have a lot of pressure put on them, and they're in the number one state where the economy matters, and that's Florida. No state has been hit harder by this housing slump than Florida. Particularly the I-4 corridor, where you go from Tampa, St. Pete, across to Orlando, and then, of course, on that southwestern side of the state, where there's been virtually no movement. The areas in Naples, for example, which is a hot place down, literally hot, down in the southern part on the western side of Florida, they really have seen a plummet in the value of homes down there. This is a big issue for Floridians, big to vote on. The candidates that seize it could easily win the whole thing. Now, that's our update for today. Our new Florida Insider magazine will be coming out, be giving out to the news media who are trying to cover the Florida primary down there. We'll have numbers tomorrow, not only from Florida, but also from up in Carolina to find out who's winning, Obama or Clinton, and also continue to look at the coming primary season as we get towards that super Tuesday that will include so many states. For right now, I'm Matt Towery for Insider Advantage, the Internet News Agency, and Southern Political Report. Have a great day.